One of the few situations that the Navier-Stokes equation can be solved for is steady laminar flow between two plates, where the fluid particles move in the x direction. There's no velocity in the y or the z direction. It's fully developed flow. And so what we end up with for Navier-Stokes is that 0 equals minus dp dx plus mu d squared u dy squared. So we can rewrite this as d squared u dy squared equals 1 over mu dp dx. So in order to solve for u, or for our velocity, we have to integrate this twice. So our first integration gives du dy equals 1 over mu dp dx times y plus our constant 1. Now we integrate it again, and we get that u equals 1 over 2 mu dp dx y squared plus c1y plus c2. And what we need to do here is solve for c1 and c2 by using boundary conditions. So if we take a look at what this looks like here, here are our two plates, and we will have our origin in the middle. So each half of the plate is a length h. So our two boundary conditions are at y equals h, the velocity equals 0 because this is the no slip condition and the plate is not moving. We can also say at y equals negative h, u also equals 0. Again, the purpose of a boundary condition is to find a velocity at a certain length or boundary. So here we're looking at our y equaling h and our y equaling negative h and knowing what the velocities are there. So this allows us to rewrite our original equation using the two boundary conditions. So the first one, since u equals 0, 0 equals 1 over 2 mu dp dx times h squared plus c1 times h plus c2. When we use the second boundary condition, same thing, we get 0 equals 1 over 2 mu dp dx. Now, even though it's negative x, when we square it, it becomes h squared. But now we have a minus c1 times h plus c2. Now, if we add these two together, what we'll end up with is something that we can use to solve for C2. So this is going to be 0 equals, we add the two of these together, so it's 1 over mu instead 1 over 2 mu, dp dx times h squared. But now the C1 cancels out plus C2 C2. And now we can solve for our C2, which equals minus 1 over 2 mu dp dx times h squared. Now to solve for C1, we just put our expression for C2 into either one of the expression. So 0 equals 1 over 2 mu dp dx h squared minus 1 over 2 mu dp dx h squared minus c1 times h. And what that shows us is that c1 equals 0. So this is the way to solve for boundary conditions. And in the end, we can rewrite our original equation, which is our U, by just replacing our C1 with 0 and our C2 with what we had calculated before. So let's write our final equation. U equals 1 over 2 times mu dp dx times y squared minus 1 over 2 mu dp dx h squared. So that's our C2. And we can simplify this by saying u equals 1 over 2 times mu dp dx y squared minus h squared. One thing to point out is that in this, we have treated dp dx and the integration as a constant because it is not a function of y.